Let's start with a complicated question. What does interest you as an artist?
I work in very long projects, so I see that, and I see that there are threads that keep running. Things that interest me a lot are issues of that are related with time, and like the idea of reformulating the notion of subjectivity, not only in terms of like a formal approach towards art making, but actually in a more in almost like a politicized way, like, which then applies to art making. And then it changes depending on what it is that, what project I am working on. So let's say, I don't know, the recent projects that I've been working on had a lot to do with one of them was like a revisiting of the space race and like trying to figure out or to understand and to give form to the reconstitution of the desire to conquer space. And that's something I've been working on for the last couple of years. That's because, as I was telling you, I work in very long forms. So something things like many different artworks come out of one idea. They tend to be quite complex and hover between like photographic images, video, and sculpture. That's sort of like the three things that I tend to work with. Another thing that I have been quite interested in is like issues of like the representation of human figure, and like especially when it is fragmented. This is very much in terms of artistic conventions. And so I've been working also in kind of like fragmentary representation and like the cut off lines as to in which the representation happens and what does that mean, like how many readings can one have to that. And for that I have been working with like a number of things and a number of materials, from like very classic sculptural materials like marble and things like that, to 3D printing, to how you say, like just to try to think, okay, so how does one handle this fragmentary representation and why in terms of materials? So that's those are current things.
Okay, I was very interested in knowing more about the Super Community, the project you're developing for the Venice Biennale this year.
That's interesting because that was something done as efflux, yeah, like and not even as efflux, but as efflux journal. But maybe like I also should explain the kind of approach, like the relationship that I have with efflux journal, because it's quite particular. Most of the time, as an artist, what tends to happen is that one reads text and then you get influenced by text. What becomes a very interesting position for me is that because I am running a theoretical journal, I can actually commission texts according to the topics and niches I'm interested in. So it's a very active relationship to research. It's not reading text, but actually saying, okay, if now I want to work with this topic, I want text to exist on this particular topic. And I think super community, I mean, like tech, and of course the three of us, there's three main editors for the journal, Brian Cornwood, Anthony Dodd, and myself. Probably the three of us have different points of attachment to the project, right? So I can only speak fully for myself, but I know that when we were developing the umbrella structure for Super Community, it was quite important to for me at least, to bring up topics that were very how to say, very present and very, very urgent in a particular sense. So I mean, it's been really interesting to do this. It's exhausting also because it's a lot of it's a lot of work, and we're only halfway through it. And it just keeps going. So it's, but it's very rewarding to see all these ideas taking shape and taking form and entering the world. And I mean, very powerful conversations that take place. What we have been doing with the journalists mostly up until Super Community was academic text in a very precise form, which is like it's a kind of format full of citations and so on. And something that happens with Super Community is that we start to take a chance with the form of the text that we publish. We are incorporating poetry, we are incorporating conversational formats, we are incorporating short fiction and things that are starting to step away from this dry, like the dry academic journal text. Yeah? And I think that also bring back a sense of poetic into the discourse that sometimes can get sidestepped in this academic effort that is very dry.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm very excited about Super Community.
Okay, I was reading some of the topics. Of course, Super Community, corruption, cosmos, planetary computing, apocalypsis, politics of shine, the art of work, art, the social commons, and Cuba. What do you like the most?
I feel like if you would ask me, if I had seven children, and you would ask me which one did you love more.
Okay, so what is the one you are mostly involved then?
In all of them, but very particularly, very particularly with corruption and with political, with corruption, with planetary computation, and with apocalypses, those are the three that I am more. And I guess because I am the one Latin American on the team, I have the closest relationship to Cuba as well. Corruption, for example, it's guest edited by this incredibly brilliant young curator, Natasha Jingwala.
Mm-hmm.
And it's also going to become an exhibition. So this is something that we have been discussing together, her and me. We work very often together. And we have been discussing this framework and this notion for a long time now. So it's also part of my artistic work. I don't see so much, I don't see a difference or a distance between my work with theory and my work with form. I think they really inform each other. They are deeply related.
Mm-hmm. How do you consider Influx today? What is the biggest strength today to you? Like the most important feature of it, the one you are most involved with?
I cannot partition it. Yeah, it's basically that it's working in several fields at once.
Yeah.
That it's not that it's like the balance that it keeps between all these aspects. Yeah, it's not. It's kind of like a little ecosystem where the announcements are related to the projects, to the exhibitions, to the journal. And it all sort of takes a shape together.
Mm-hmm.
Many times, and this is because of how it grew, yeah? It started in a very simple idea. And then, the real development of Influx is basically just Anton and me. There is nobody else involved. There are other people that work in different aspects of the platform, let's say. I would call Influx a platform.
Mm-hmm.
And different people come and participate in different aspects, but the large view is something that it's only Anton and me, because now it's such a complex, it has so many elements. Of course, people would ask me, oh my God, how did you come up with that, with such a complex idea? And of course, we didn't come up with such a complex idea. Yeah, it started very small, and the process was very rhizomatic and very organic. And it was very clear that certain things needed to happen. For Anton and I, it's very easy to work together. We kind of like read each other's minds, and we have a very, they kind of like the same nose, yeah? Like we smell the same things at the same time. So it's like we are like different aspects of like the same person in that kind of sense. And the fact that we are able to balance all these elements that normally would not coexist, I think is what makes Efflux strong. Just the announcements or just the journal or just the projects would not have the strength that the whole thing has together.
Mm-hmm. So it's this complexity.
It's not resting on any one thing harder than on the others. I think they all, it's a successful system in terms of the relationships it has set within itself.
So it's complex and democratic, like say, like horizontal?
Pretty much.